Are you thinking about making a SharePoint site for your project? Oh, well, I love SharePoint sites. I'm a big believer in them for continuity for your team, for projects. And in this video, I'm going to share with you how to make a SharePoint site for a project that's going to keep your team connected. And if you also need help to build the right skills and mindset for projects, well, don't go any further because I actually have a free webinar that really shares the essentials that you need to know to be successful for projects, and it's free. And the link is underneath this video just for you. Hi, if you're new here, welcome. My name is Adriana Girdler, and you have landed on the best practical project management channel out there in YouTube world. My personal opinion. But on that note, please subscribe to this awesome community because it tells YouTube we're doing a really good job. Now let's get to how to build a project SharePoint site. Let's go. Why make a SharePoint site for projects? It's really simple. It is your one-stop shop for everything you need on a project. And what I love about it, and I direct people to all the time, is when you get bombarded with emails of, I need this, I need that. All you have to do is give them the link to your SharePoint site, ensure they have access, and they can get it all themselves. You're teaching people how to fish, and that is really important. You're not the one who's giving or trying to control everything. So really critical, great for communication, and great for version control too. How to create a SharePoint site. You know what? Let's just hop on my computer and get right to it. So to create a SharePoint site, you need to have access to Office 365. And depending on your organization, you may have to reach out to your IT department to create one for you. Or if you have access to your Office 365 homepage, you can do it yourself. So let's check out that option. You're going to go to your Office homepage and you're going to click on these 9 dots. When you do that, it's going to take you to some other Microsoft 365 products and you want to click on SharePoint. When you do that, you're going to get to the SharePoint site and you're going to click on Create Site. When you do that, it's going to take you to 2 options. Click on the team site because this allows for you to upload the documents, you know who's in it, you can track resourcing. It really is the best way to do it. Once you've done that, you're going to add your site name, whatever it's going to be, usually your project name and the site description, and you're going to click Next. And upon that, you have an option of adding members. I recommend highly do not add members here. Add them after you're done the site. Why? Because they're going to get a notification of being added to a site, which you haven't even started yet. So you want to do that last. And once that's done, you now have your SharePoint site and you as the only member. So now let's go into how we now clean this up to make it an actual project SharePoint site. Now that you have your SharePoint site, you can see everything that you're given, but this is not going to solve your needs. You need to customize it. So in order to do that, we always go to this edit section here. We're going to click on edit. And upon clicking on the edit, we're now going to delete some stuff because there's no need for us to have this. So I click on here, you can see there's a little garbage can. I'm going to delete that web part. I'm going to delete this one. I'm going to get everything nice and clean. And I don't need any of this. So what you should now get is a plain site. I'm also going to turn off the comments. I personally don't like that. And I'm going to close that out. And now you can see I've deleted everything. So what does that mean when I republish it? It means we actually have nothing on the site. Okay, so now that it's plain, you have lots of options here. The first thing you want to do is you want to always go into the edit. And in the edit, you're going to see the framework of a SharePoint site and its sections. And within this section, you have these web parts. And when you click on the plus sign, you can see some of the most frequently used that I use here, which is my top line. And then you have a whole bunch of other options. I highly recommend you play around with this. You'll see what's going to work for you. Every project is different. Every project manager is different. And it'll give you a really good idea as to what you want to add. But I always say the first thing you need to do is you need to welcome people to your project site. So I always make my first one text. And I always say, welcome to project. We're going to call this MAPS because that's the acronym of this project. Welcome to project MAPS. And then sometimes I'll even do your one stop shop for all your project needs.
For some people, you need to educate them that this is where they gotta go. So what I wanna do now is I'm gonna go and make this a header because I really want it to pop. And your one-stop shop, am I happy with that? Yeah, I'm okay with that. So what I wanna do now is I wanna center that. I'm gonna center this. And I'm feeling pretty good with that. So to me, that's good. So I'm gonna republish that. And that now gives you an idea as to your section of your title. Okay, so now we have the title, but you know what? I want to fool around with this a little bit more. I just realized I want to put in a scope statement right beside here because that's something my team is always going to be questioning. So I'm going to go to edit, and what do? I already made this a single section, so I'm going to go over here, and I'm going to click, and I'm going to make this two columns. Oops, I wanted to do this one. Here we go. Make that two columns, and I'm going to delete this one above because I don't need it. You can see sometimes you kind of have to do double clicking. So what am I going to do here? I'm now going to go to my frequently used, and I'm going to go scope, project, scope, statement, do a enter, and I'm going to go over to my charter. And I'm going to do a cut and paste, control C, and I'm going to go right over here and make that a paste. Now, like always, I like to do a little bit of a header, so I'm going to do that. And I think I'm going to make this slightly smaller because I don't want it to pop out as much. There we go. So now I'm going to republish that. I'm really happy with that. Now I got welcome to project maps, project scope statement. Now I want to start doing some additional documentation by linking some things to actual project documents. Now, the one thing I recommend is you actually go into documents first and you download all of the documents that you need. So I've already done that. I've gone into this folder and I've added some documents that I know for sure I want people to do, but I'm going to show you how to do this. So when you get in here, because I have one more folder I want to add, I'm going to call it charter. And what you can't see is I actually have my charter, and I'm going to swing it over here and drop and drag, or drag and drop, and put it into this document here, right? This folder. So you may be asking, Adriana, why are you doing folders for everything? Well, it keeps it neat. And it's really important too, for some documents, you're not going to want to link to the actual document. For example, if we go into our project plan, and this project plan may be something that gets updated constantly. If I link to the actual document, then every single time I update it, it's going to break the link on my homepage when I add all it. And you'll see everything in a moment. That's why you always want to, in my personal opinion, create folders, link things to a folder so that the folder opens up and then people will have to do one more click in order to get to the actual document. But it's going to save you the long run of having to manage broken links. So now that you've dumped all your documents, we're going to now go over and create the next element. Now let's go back to edit. When you go back to edit, you want to do your section. I'm good with the one. I want to now add my hero. I really like heroes, and basically it's a visualization of your key documents with links. That's why I told you to do the documents before, because now we're going to select a link and you already have everything on your site. Now, one thing I find is there's little nuances when it comes to linking stuff. And if you want to link a folder, I find you actually have to go to the actual URL. So I usually create two sites. Do you see that? And I want to do this charter. So now that I clicked on that charter, I have a URL. So I'm going to do Control C, go back here. I'm going to upload from a link, Control V. It's going to say add, and now I have a link right there, and it naturally does a picture for me. So what I want to now share with you is how do I change this up and how do I get more information? So each box will have its own little edit, and you can see there's the link. I'm going to call this box is project charter, and I have some options here. I want my background image. I could use a custom image. And if I scroll down here, I can change that custom image by, again, going into stock images. That's a nice thing about SharePoint. They have some stock images. So maybe what I want to do here is I maybe want to do a theme. Let me do maybe, I'll do a modern theme. Why not? And I'm going to use that white one. And again, you can do whatever you want. So now that's Project Charter. There's nothing else here that I really feel is necessary. And I'm basically done that. Now, with the magic of the internet and YouTube and video, I'm going to pre-populate all these for you. So now we have everything populated in our hero. You can see we have the charter. And as I click over here, it goes directly to the folder charter with the document here. And as I said, if you ever were to change the name or add a date to it, you're in the folder. That's what you've linked to. You haven't linked to the document. And if you want to go into the document, then here you go. You click on it and it's there and everybody can access it. It really is the thing of beauty. And this is actually an example of the Project Slay charter that you get in my online course, Slay Project Management. So if we want to move back, I'm going to go back home and you can see everything else. Now here's something to take note. You may not have all the documents that you need, but you want to set up your site. So I just do a document place card holder document, which is literally that. It's saying this document is just a place card holder until I construct and finalize the document that I need. So that's just a little FYI for you. Now let's go back to the home and let's go back to edit. And let's now talk about some other sections that I would add in here. I definitely want to add another section that is going to be two columns. And I really like, I'm going to go here for the A portion because it's text. And what I'm going to add over here are some things that I currently do on my site, which is some project highlights. And I'm going to do a little copy and paste from another thing, actually from another screen. Put it in here. So I like this. So it allows me to highlight some project things that are coming down the pike. If you like to do that, or you may want to do, which is what I really like to do. I'm going to go for here as a text. And again, I'm going to cut and paste it. I love team expectations. I like to get very clear on that. And I like putting it in here because now my team knows. So here I have these two sort of side by side. And if you're wondering, Adriana, this is so different. How can I make it the same so it looks really good? Not a problem. See how that's header one? I'm going to make sure that this is header one as well. And it wasn't. It was under normal. So now see how they're both big? And now they're both actually have the information that I need. So I'm going to republish that so you can see it. And wow, this site is really coming together. I got my welcomes, my project scope statement. I have all of my key documentations already uploaded and I've links to them so that people can easily access it. And you can see this is what's really nice. It's very visual and it's pretty, let's be honest. Then I have project highlights and project team expectations. I could add more to this. Again, very simply go to the edit, the section, pick the web part that you want. Now, what you could also do here is let's now go back to edit and let's kind of color code everything because I like to break it up. And so I'm going to go over here to this section. I got my section part. You notice the colors here. If I were to change my theme, and my theme right now is green, I would now republish that. And you can see how coming to this site, it really pops out. Welcome to Project Maps, Project Scope Statement. Here's my hero. I could leave this white here, or I may want to change it up as well, which I think I'm going to. And I'm now, I think I'm going to make that light green, just so there's some nice, just really cuts it in a nice way. It just makes it look pretty. So there you go. There is your very basic beginning of a project SharePoint site that you can update, change, move around, figure out what you need to do, and everybody has access to everything. So I highly, highly recommend this.
Don't forget to save your free seat on my project management webinar that I talked about at the beginning of this video. It is so worth it. You're going to love it and it's free. So check it out. Link is under this video. See you next time.